how to spread this message in a mass media. Just by printing the book and distributing the book is not going to take us to the next level. Like, media is the main thing. Have you organized something like a debate on the TV or something?
See, I am available to go anywhere there's an audience. Yeah. But the difficult thing is that part of this infiltration has been through the media also. Media will not take things, you know, media, a very wonderful review that Gokul, where is Gokul? Gokul knows, wonderful review lady in Canada has done. And, you know, she sent it to various prominent Indian newspapers that would not carry it. It's very difficult to push your way through. I'm talking about the outlook and places like that. So it is very difficult to get into, break into this media, which I don't know how to do. As far as debates are concerned, my policy is that one way you can get a lot of attention is you provoke an opponent into a debate. So Princeton University 2 weeks ago had a debate between me and Reverend Thompson, who is an Indian Christian pastor from the local church, Methodist Church, and Princeton University organized it. So it's a gathering a little bit bigger than this. And the in the next within the next few days, we are going to upload on our website the whole 2 hours of videotape. So you can see what it was. It was very lively, and by the end, the guy was quite defensive and not as aggressive as he started out to be. And he brought a friend of somebody along who was in the audience. So when they were not able to handle the questions, when they were not able to answer my responses, then that guy in the audience started shouting. And so it's good. We kept quiet. Everybody was very calm and relaxed. Nobody hit back at him. But this guy was raising his voice and waving his arms and yelling and screaming at Hindus and India. He's an Indian guy, another fellow friend of his. Made a big scene, and we have that whole thing on the video also. So we will put that up. So we have made an attempt to go and really debate opponents, real opponents, people who will really take us on. I am not afraid. So, but how to get more visibility for this, I don't know. I mean, I'm doing my best. We've got an extremely detailed website. If you go to www.breakingindia.com, you will see videos, even this video, we're taking it, and within 10 days after this event, we will put it up. So all the videos we did in Chennai, all the videos in Delhi, Princeton, everywhere, Atlanta, they're going to keep going online. And we have a e-group which has now almost 800 members, but that's trivial compared to lakhs and lakhs of people who need to know. So I don't myself know what else we can do. Another thing we're doing is a Tamil edition is coming, which is from a very nice press in Tamil in Chennai. They've just finished the translation. So they're going to have this big hardbound book exactly like this in Tamil, and they're going to print, 50,000 copies or very lakh copies, because it will be low priced for local distribution within Tamil Nadu. So we are doing everything we can as researchers and scholars. Now where we need help is, we need others to come and say, okay, other people have to do something now, I don't know what, maybe they have to make this through a documentary and put documentary for people who will not read. And maybe this has to be turned into petitions. Now certainly those who've got political clout should take this idea to your senators, to your contacts in the government, and say, why is the U.S. government, why, just like U.S. government would not support activities that are inimical or against our national interest in some foreign country, why don't you declare India a strategic partner, and anything that undermines India's sovereignty will be something the federal government will not have anything to do with, and federal government will withdraw funding of such organizations. It would go a long way. But the U.S. Commission on Religious Freedom is still the Republican right-wing dominated people, and Obama has not changed even one of them. That's quite shameful, because I would have thought that he would have the audacity to change some of those guys and put new people and maybe have some Hindus in there. But none of that has happened. So you guys can do something in terms of lobbying, putting some pressure to get the right kind of people in. But that's a very good point.